Muhammad Faris Hanuddin was lucky to escape death and serious injuries after being buried alive in a Taman Idaman landslide on Saturday. He was headed home on his motorcycle when the ground beneath him gave way.
Memang gelap lah masa tu. Tak puas lah pun sebab tak nampak sebab selalu ikut jalan tu. So, sedar dah dekat bawah.
The 21-year-old gym assistant was pulled out of the deluge by about three people and he had received treatment at the hospital. He lost his motorcycle, wallet and mobile phone in the incident. His family and other residents have moved out of their homes to a temporary shelter at a school in the area.
Sebab ini kan kawasan taman yang atas sikit kan? So, kita expect selamat lah, tak kena banjir. Cuma,
orang
tua
belakang kata.
Waktu saya tengok tu, dia dah runtuh half lah daripada jalan.
Okay.
Ada satu kereta, dia suruh alih. So, sempat alih. Lepas tu, dalam pukul satu-satu macam tu, dia dah...
Memang nak cakap jemah tu memang ada lah. Macam-macam lah fikir. Okay. Fikir anak bini lah. Okay. Benda lain atau benda tu biar dulu lah. Pindah lah.
Pindah. Sebab dia apa sewa?
Sebab fobia lah tu dah jadi macam ni lah. Sekarang nak tunggu ni nak kandang nyawa lah.
Bila pemaju rumah ni dulu, dia menimbus tapak lombong ni dulu. Mereka tak buat habis. Bila hujan, air akan tanah itu akan bergerak. Mungkin malam tadi, itu terus meluncur lah.
Authorities said the landslide damaged 10 cars and caused some houses to collapse. The area is declared unsafe for occupation at the moment. Security forces are watching out the homes, while contractors are strengthening the slopes to prevent any landslides from recurring. Selangor Esko member Zaidi Abdul Talib said, the Public Works Department will do all it can to stop underground water flow and take measures to stop the soil movement. A water main had also burst as a result of the landslide in Jalan Utama Serenda, Idaman, and this has caused water disruption in Desa Melo, Desa Anggerik, Taman Idaman, Kampung Orang Asli Serenda, and Pusat Serenti Serenda.